So, Chuck, we have new driver death rates out for 2020 model year vehicles and equivalent. So driver death rates, this is something that we calculate like every 3 years. Can you just talk about what we can learn from driver death rates?
Well, it's a complement to the laboratory crash test that we do on new vehicles. So this gives us the real-world experience of those vehicles. We have to wait a few years, of course, to give them that exposure out there. But then we can see how well did they do, not just in the types of crashes that we test, but in general, out in the world.
Right, because crash tests give us a good way to kind of compare vehicles in like a given vehicle class, right? But driver death rates kind of take everything into account.
Right, right. And there's also, it includes the way drivers behave, because these rates are not how well you do once you're in a crash, but it's also how likely are you to get into a crash. It's a combination of those two.
Right. So let's just talk about the driver death rates. What were kind of the big takeaways when we talk about driver death rates for 2020 models?
First, see what we always see is that the smaller vehicles did poorly, especially the mini cars. They always have the highest driver death rates when we do this. And the bigger vehicles tend to have lower driver death rates. Minivans usually come out to be pretty good. Minivans and luxury vehicles always tend to be the best. And some of that is because of their relative size, but I think a lot of that is the way they're driven.
So you mentioned small cars. So just to get it out of the way, kind of the dubious honor of highest death rate here goes to the Mitsubishi Mirage G4. It's a mini car, a very small car, doesn't have a lot of weight behind it, right? So that probably contributes to that.
Yeah, it's about as small as you can get, around 2,000 pounds. And it's going up against 4,000-pound cars and 6,000, 7,000-pound pickups. So it's always at a disadvantage.
And on the other end of the spectrum, the lowest driver death rates, there are actually four models with a death rate of zero. The BMW X3 four-wheel drive, the Lexus ES350, Mercedes-Benz E-Class sedan four-wheel drive, and the Nissan Pathfinder two-wheel drive, and obviously a lot of vehicles in between. Another thing that kind of stood out in the data was the muscle cars. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, that was a little new this year. It's been a while since we've seen these muscle cars, these high-performance, huge engine, quick acceleration cars coming to our list. I think the last time was probably in the 90s when the Corvette used to show up every now and then. But now we're seeing actually four that came into the list this year. The Chevy Camaro, the Ford Mustang, and then the Dodge Charger and Challenger.
We also looked at kind of the flip side of the coin, which is how frequently people are dying in other cars when they crash with a given vehicle. Before we jump into that, which I think is really interesting, I just wanted to zero in on sort of the all driver death rate average. It says here that it increased from the last time we did this, from 38 deaths per million registered vehicle years, from 36 the last time around. Does that kind of speak to any bigger trends?
It's just a trend in the general environment. If you look at the number of fatalities in all vehicles over the past few years, it's spiked quite a bit. We're up to over 40,000 deaths a year, which we hadn't seen for many years. And that's reflected in the experience of these vehicles. It's not that the vehicles are getting worse, it's that the environment is getting worse.
So for the first time this year, we kind of looked at the other side of the puzzle as well, which is, you know, how frequently people are dying in the other cars. Why did we do that this time around for this so-called other driver death rate list?
It's always been in the back of our minds because we explain the high death rates for mini cars as being they're too small and they're meeting up against these much larger cars. And if you think about it, that just means the much larger cars are doing a lot of damage. And so we decided, why don't we look at the death rates in other vehicles, in the opposing vehicles, for these same 181 models that we gave ratings for here. And we found what we expected is that the largest vehicles, the really super heavy pickups, were having the highest opposing vehicle driver death rates.
The superlative there is to the Ram 3500 crew cab long bed four-wheel drive. It's a very large pickup that had an other driver death rate of 189. I noticed that there is some crossover between the highest driver death rates and the highest other driver death rates. Can you speak about what we saw in terms of that crossover and what might explain that?
Well, the muscle cars end up on both lists. They have high rates of deaths to their drivers and high rates of deaths to other drivers. And you can't explain that by size, but you can explain it by speed. That's the other factor that comes into crashes that affects the severity of it. And these are marketed as speedy cars, cars that you can go fast in. And I think that marketing is influencing the drivers, and they are going fast and too fast, I would say. And they're not only killing their drivers, but they're running into other drivers and killing them as well.
You know, we've got these new driver death rates. They're just posted, and they are at IIHS.org. There are a lot of models that you're not going to find among the driver death rates list. Can you talk about, you know, what it took to sort of make this list and why some models aren't on there?
Our rule for making the list is you have to have at least 100,000 vehicle years of exposure.
A sample size, essentially, a minimum
sample size.
Right,
it's a sample size.
Yeah.
And that's because we want to be able to control the precision of these estimates.
Got it. Well, so if folks are interested in learning more about driver death rates, they can head to IIHS.org, where they can check out sort of the highest and the lowest, and also can review driver death rates from those models that fall in between. Chuck, really appreciate you walking us through that.
Well, thank you.